Hey guys, thanks for clicking on my video. Today I'm going to be doing empties. These are just current empties. Usually I do these monthly with my monthly favorites, but the last couple of months I don't even know. So I'm going to go through some things and I have a pretty hefty bag of stuff that I just want to throw out. So I'm not going to do this in any particular order because I just want to get from the top to the bottom. Of course, dry shampoo. I live through dry shampoo. If I don't have dry shampoo, I feel kind of icky and gross. My hair is so thin and it gets oily very quickly at the roots, so I do need a dry shampoo to kind of refresh my hair, even the day after I shower. So it's not even like 4 days in. Like, I need it the day after I shower. So the one that I use is the Batiste Deep Brown. But I just recently started using a different one from this like old brand from Walgreens. It's in a bigger can and they just came out with dry shampoos. It used to just be hairsprays. So I'm not gonna be using these for now. Those other ones are a little bit cheaper and I kind of like it. So this might be one of the last ones you see in a while. Next thing are actually interesting. And I don't think I've showed this before. These are beauty blenders. After a while, they tend to break apart. There's a ton of little tears on each of the black ones. They're a little bit softer, I think, than the pink ones. And then I have this Real Techniques one, which is pretty old too, and there's a ton of tears. So at this point, I'm just like, I couldn't even remember how long I've had them. So I just thought, you know what? Let me throw this out. So that's why I'm getting rid of this. I have a new one that I'm gonna be starting to use, but I was using like three interchangeably and I needed to just like not do that because it would make me forget when I started using it. So I couldn't really track how long I should throw it out or not. But these are going bye-bye. Next is this micellar water from Garnier. This is the best eye makeup remover I've ever tried. And this is me trying like Clinique. I think there was a L'Oreal one. There was a Sonia Kashuk one. This by far is the best one. This is the one with the blue cap. So the blue cap one is specifically for makeup that is like long lasting or waterproof makeup and things like that. I use waterproof mascara almost every day. So I need this, and what I do is I just pour some, I shake it first, pour some onto my makeup eraser, massage it into my eyes, and then I'll go in and clean my face. And I never have any like leftover makeup on my eyes. There is some residue in here because there is a little bit of oil, but it's not as oily and as really like gritty as the Clinique one. The Clinique one, I know for a fact, it's extremely oily and it leaves a ton of oil behind. So this is the best one. I already have one in my bathroom because I can't really live without it. And they also sell mini ones at Ulta that I bought because I was traveling a lot at the time. The next thing is this Thayer's Witch Hazel. This one is in the rose petal formula. This is like a toner. So you would remove your makeup, wash your face with cleanser, and then you would take a cotton pad and put this in there and just clean out your face before you use moisturizer. And what that does, it just kind of like cleans out anything extra on your skin, and it also kind of tones and like neutralizes and balances your face before moisturizer. So I really love this in... I really like this when I just like need a refresher too. So let's say like I wash my face for a while and later on I want to do my makeup and refresh my makeup, but I don't want to wash my face all the way because I don't want it to dry out. I'll take this toner and it just makes my face that much better to put on like moisturizer and everything like that. So it's like a refresher, but in a liquid form as opposed to a spray. This is like my favorite. My sister has the cucumber one. I love the rose petal smell. So there's a few formulas that you can try out. And I believe she got this at Whole Foods. So they kind of sell it at those like natural type of stores. I also did buy a backup of that because so good. Then I am getting rid of this Mitchum dry shampoo. I'm sorry, not dry shampoo. I'm so used to these cans. This is like a dry deodorant spray. I was just trying to use something a little bit lighter than like a full-on deodorant. Sometimes a deodorant, it has like a huge thick layer onto my armpits and it takes forever to scrub off. So this was like kind of like my alternative. This one's in the scent Powder Fresh. This is an antiperspirant and deodorant. I like the Mitchum one. There's a Degree one, I believe, but I like the Mitchum one better. Anyways, this is the Advanced Control. I really like it and it smells good. Oh, the next facial spray is also the rose water from Maria Badescu. I really love this one too. I just hated the sprayer. The sprayer is just like squirts. Like, it just looks like a generic bottle, and it kind of is. The fixing spray from Milani has like the best spray. MAC Fix Plus has the best one, but I think I broke it trying to refill it and repackage it, so it didn't work out for me. But anyways, I like the formula inside of it. Again, it was just like a way to kind of refresh my makeup or rehydrate it in the winter when I was really, really dry. So I like the scent of roses. My sister hates it, but I know that not everybody likes the scent of rose. But I'm not gonna buy this again because I do have that Milani one, and I think I'm just gonna like use that up and then instead of having multiple ones. This is a Salon Perfect strip of lashes. These are like a set of five. They were the 615s. I put a picture up right here. They look really, really cool. They're very similar to MAC 35s, if you're familiar with that type of lash. It's a beautiful lash. It's very, very dramatic. It just depends on how you wear it and with what makeup underneath. What I will say is that whenever it was starting to get a little bit old and dingy, I would snip it in the center of one lash and then use the opposite and then stick them on the lashes. Because what I found is it just does a really great way of like kind of tapering out a lash without like looking like the choppiness made sense on like a half strip. So I really like this one. I have another backup of this. These you can get at Walmart. Again, this is a 615s. They do have 614s, which are very similar to like Ardell Wispies, but they're a little bit longer. So the Salon Perfect ones are really, really great. If you guys haven't tried them, which I'm sure almost everybody has because it's such a popular brand now, I would go to Walmart and try these out. They're awesome. Next lash is the Ardell 811s. These come in that little striped band. These are like their mink, like their faux mink, lightweight Invisiband lashes. These are amazing. I really do love these. As soon as I found these, I was like, let me try them. I personally can't really get with the like those mink lashes that have a very, very thick band. I don't really feel like they kind of wear nicely. They're just not comfortable. But these are like as fluttery and as thick as those kind of lashes look, but they are much more comfortable. The style that I got was 811. It's actually the ones that I'm wearing right now. So these are just so great. So I have several backups of these, but every once in a while when they go on sale, I try to stock up on these. A foundation that I kind of finally got rid of, which I'm like surprised that I even did, was the L'Oreal Pro Glow in 209. The 209 one is like my tan version or my dark color. It's not really a good match really at any point. I don't think I've gotten this dark in the summer, but I love to use it in the perimeter of my face or to mix this with other foundations that are a little bit too light. It's a great mixing foundation. And the reason I say that is because the formula is very light, so it kind of morphs into whatever other formula you're mixing it with. It doesn't break down like, let's say, a long-lasting matte formula. This is like a perfect like mixer. So I already have a backup of 209 that I'm using now, but I love, love, love this. And it's beautiful by itself. I mix it with a lighter color of the same kind of formula, but it is beautiful by itself. However, it's great to mix with other foundations when it's just a little bit too light. I got rid of this NYC liquid liner. It was pretty old and it was time. So I've replaced this since with the NYX liquid liner, and I really like it. I think it stays on much better than this one. This one, I remember I would like have teary eyes or maybe like it would rain or something and it would transfer and kind of like smudge. And like break apart easily, but the NYX one does a really great job, and it really, you have to kind of like work that waterproof matte because it doesn't come off as easily. So this is, I'm actually kind of okay that it's gone, to be honest. Then I'm getting rid of this Motives, it was like a lash adhesive, glitter adhesive. I just don't use this enough or at all. And it was kind of sitting in my drawer and it was pretty old, so I just needed to get rid of it. I didn't really use it that much. But it didn't keep on stuff that long, to be honest. But I don't wear a lot of glitter, so. A great adhesive, actually, for the lashes is the Revlon Precision adhesive. This, I guess it's discontinued or something, because I used to see it all the time at my CVS, not Walgreens, but CVS, and then all of a sudden it just like disappeared. So I don't know where they went or like why they're like off the shelves, but they have other, there's a ton of different brands that come up with this kind of brush tip, so maybe it was that. The black one is really great too. That's the one that I'm using now, but the white one is so, so good too. It's super strong. It feels like your eye is gonna be, like your whole eye is getting pulled off. So I love this for beginners because it doesn't need a ton of time to dry. and you can really, really make sure that each corner is locked in. But yeah, they discontinued it. So I'm gonna try a couple other ones. I think I bought one from Ardell that's similar to this. So I'll try it and see if it works. I think, or Kiss. But I haven't tried it yet, so I'm still using up the black one. The next eyeliner that I'm getting rid of is this iTech from Milani. It was a great one, but it dried out. And I think, I know what it was. My little sisters were using it and they fucked it up. it was really cute. We were playing with makeup and actually I fucked it up. I was using it on their liner and then it dried out and it was gross, so. I have another one, but I'm trying to find a matte felt tip eyeliner. And I can't find one that's matte. All right, the next empty is the Stay Don't Stray by Benefit. So I really liked this at one point. I was really happy with it. The reason why is because it's very similar to like a concealer, but it also has a little bit of tack in there. So it was great for like if you needed to add on like a very shimmery color on top, but if you just wanted to use regular eyeshadows or matte eyeshadows, then you would just brush some like translucent powder on top of this. The color I got was in medium deep. So eventually it started to kind of like turn. And I think it's because I had it for a long time. I don't know if I'm gonna repurchase this. I liked it, but I couldn't see how much was left. I couldn't see where I was grabbing it. I couldn't see if it separated. So it was just kind of like, I don't know. It was kind of getting sketchy. So, but it did work really well. I don't think it works better than like the 24-hour base from MAC per se, but it does have that extra quality of like, of that like concealer-esque type thing. So I think people love it because of that, but I won't buy it again. Can't believe I finished this finally. This is my first ever Anastasia bra product even. And this one's in the color dark brown. It's the duo. So it broke on me at one point. I chopped it up, mixed it up, and so it was just one flat color. So I already have a backup to this, but you guys, I went through it all. I tried every like last bit of it and it just needs to go. I use this a lot for when I travel. I love using this as like a crease color to deepen up the crease and also to the lower lash line. So I love this product for that reason too. I often use these in my kit as eyeshadows if I just need something a little bit darker. But I'm surprised that it's finally gone. It's like lasted forever. Then the last product is this Motives mascara. This just ended up drying out on me pretty quickly. I liked it for a second, but I don't know, it just kind of was just eh, to be honest, compared to my other mascaras. So this was great while it lasted, but it did dry out on me pretty quickly. All right, that's the end of my empties. I went through it all pretty quickly, but I haven't gone through those in a while and I was doing monthly favorites, so I'm so glad that I was able to do that now and dump them for real, like delete their number, they're gone forever. If you guys have any questions about any of those products, please leave the comment or the question below. I'm happy to answer any questions you guys have about those things. I have a couple makeup tutorials coming up soon, so if you guys wanna check those out, make sure that you're subscribing to my channel. And in the meantime, you can look at all these other videos that I post right here. I'll see you guys later, bye.